Bavkshe. Good evening, dear ladies. I would like to bless all of us, Bezrat Hashem, that we will all have the zchut to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu Berachamim Murim B'mera B'yameinu, Amen. Eliyahu Hanavi, Eliyahu Tishbi, Eliyahu Giladi, B'mera Hamshech B'davin, Eliyahu Hanavi Zachur L'Tov. And may we all have the zchut, Bezrat Hashem, to see the building of Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi B'mera B'yameinu, Amen. כי עין בעין ראו בתשובת בני ציון, נתת קום תרחם ציון, כי עת לחננה כי בא מועד, השיבנו אדוני אליך ונושוב החדש ימינו כקדם. And we all have the זכות בעזרת השם to go to ארץ ישראל on the wings of eagle. And בסייעתא דשמיא, may we all have the זכות to have part in ארץ ישראל. I was thinking a lot if to give the shiur this week because it's still very hard. Isama. Because it's still very hard for me to speak, but I decided that I'm going, b'siyata dishma, I'm going to do all of this. Leilu nishmat Rabbi Haim Yosef ben David, hanolad mirachel, alav ha-shalom ti nishmat ha-tzorah b'tzorah chayim, b'siyata dishma, v'gam ha-baal shel tzir alea, el chananel mordechai, ben rachel, alav ha-shalom ti nishmat ha-tzorah chayim, b'ezrat Hashem, v'lekol mi, kol ha-nishamot she'en lahem mi she'emar alehem kadish, שהקדוש ברוך הוא ייתן להזדכות איתנו. That they will be zocher with all of us, בעזרת השם. It's very hard to speak about Rabbi Chaim in a past tense, and it's very hard to give the shiur. So, בסייעתא דשמיא, I need a lot of סייעתא דשמיא today. Rabbi Chaim, Esther Ruth, can you please mute everyone?
Yes, Rabbanit, I already muted everyone, so everyone please make sure that you are muted. We are already on Facebook and also Rabbanit to concentrate. It's hard for them to see again Rabbanit to do this shiur, so please make sure that you don't unmute yourselves. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you. I want to tell you that I love you all. Thank you for all of the empathy and the kindness and all of the love that you shared with us in these hard times. It's really touching, and you know a person only when there are hard times, there's hardship. Then you know who the person is. Because if everything's good, זה לא חוכמה, it's not a wisdom, בסייעתא דשמיא, to help a person. But when a person comes to hardship, this is the time to show your love and your kindness and your empathy, בסייעתא דשמיא. And I send thank you to Hashem for all of you, Baruch Hashem. I know why Hashem loves Israel, why Hashem loves the children of Israel. And I would like to tell you that Rabbi Chaim passed away on Motzei Shabbos of Vav Kislev. And it was really, Motzei Shabbat, it's already like Sunday. And this is the first day of Parashat Vayetze. And it's written in Parashat Vayetze, Vayetze Yaakov Miber Sheva, וילך הרנה. And Yaakov went out of Beersheba, he departed from Beersheba, and he went to Haran, he went towards Haran. Rashi says, לא היה צריך לכתוב אלא וילך יעקב חרנה. He says, why would Hashem see that it will be written that Moshe departed from Beersheba and he went towards Haran? It was enough to be written that Moshe went toward Haran. We all know that he went from Be'er Sheva, so why would Hashem write it twice? So he says, Velama, Velama iskir yetziyato, and why did he remind us of his departure from Be'er Sheva? Ela megid, sheyetziat tzadik, because it says that when a tzadik goes out of the place, yetziat tzadik min hamokom osa roshem. It makes a void when a tzaddik goes out of the place. Why? It says, "Shebezman shatzaddik, shebezman shatzaddik ba'ir." While the tzaddik is in the city, hu hoda, hu ziva, hu hadara. When the tzaddik is in the city, he is the glory, he is the splendor, and he is the beauty of the place. Once the tzaddik goes out, yatsa misham, pana hoda, pana ziva, pana hadara. When the tzaddik goes out of the place, like Yaakov HaTzaddik went out of Beersheba, it says When he departed, its glory, splendor, and beauty departed with him. I would like to show you what does it mean, glory, splendor, and beauty. It says, Hoda starts, the glory starts with a hey, the splendor starts with a zayin, and the beauty starts with a hey. We have hey, zayin, behey. Hey in Gematria numerical value is 5, zayin is 7, and another hey is 5. Together it's 17. 17 keminyan tov. That all of the goodness of this tzaddik that he bestowed by Hashem upon the city that he lived goes away with him. So everybody feels that this tzaddik went away. So Rashi says that's why it's written twice, Vayetze Yaakov, and Yaakov departed, because once Yaakov the tzaddik went out of Be'er Sheva, they all felt it in Be'er Sheva, in the land of Israel. They all felt it because its glory, its splendor, and its beauty went out with him. And all of the initials is Keminyan Tov, is in the numerical value of Tov. Rabbi Haim Yosef ben David, B'siyata Dishmaya, he always used to say that Hashem Haim ben David. He used to say that he is Chabad, because Chaim starts with a Chet, Ben, the son, starts with a Bet, and Daled, David, starts with a, is Daled. So, Biyachad, it's Chabad, Chokhma, Bina, Vadat, which means wisdom, understanding, and knowing Hashem. And this is really what he was, B'siyata Dishmaya. And if we look at the name of his mother, Rabbi Chaim ben Rachel, Alav Shalom Tishvato Tzorah B'Tzor Chaim Srutot Agen Aleinu, Chaim starts with a chet, Ben starts with a bet, and Rachel with a resh, which is chaver, a friend. And he was a friend to everybody he knew. Everyone. He would speak to them in the level of their eyes. Chas v'shalom. No one would hear him speak with pride or honor, always in the level of the eye of the person that he spoke with. I would like to tell you a few things before we continue about when a person passes away from Shulchan Aruch. It says, because I know a lot of people now lose people and widows and the yetomim, so orphans. So I would like to tell you what Shulchan Aruch says about this. It says in Siman in chapter 215. Ein mitkashin malamet yoter midai. It's forbidden to grieve excessively over the dead. It says, Al tifku lamet v'al tanudulo. Do not weep for the dead and do not bemoan him. And our sages says, they say, v'chi efshar lomar ken, you can say this, not to mourn the dead, because you feel the space that is left over. You see that the head of the house, he doesn't sit in the head of the table. There's Shabbat, there's high holidays. You feel that he is missing. So how can you say that? The sages say, Ela al tifku lamet yoter midai. It says, but Hashem meant that you are not allowed to weep too much for the dead. And he says, Haketzad, Shlosha yamim lebechi, 3 days. How should we mourn? 3 days are appointed for weeping. 7 days for mourning and 30 days for abstaining, for wearing the siyata dishmaya, ironed clothes, and from having the haircut. And Hashem says, Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Im atem rashaim lerachem alav yoter mimeni? Hashem says, are you permitted to show him more compassion than Hashem does? Hashem says, there's no one that has compassion for his children more than Hashem. We don't have compassion for the children better than Hashem. Hashem has compassion because he knows what he does. He sees from the beginning of the world to the end of the world. That's why, B'siyata Dishmaya, in these hardships, when we go through hardship, and it can be everything. It can be when a widow that goes for hardship, the husband passed away, an orphan. It can be a hardship, chas v'shalom, of trial, of sickness, any hardship. The hardship with the children, hardship with the things that we're going through. any hardship that we are going through, dear ladies, this is a real, true test of emunah, of faith in Hashem. How much we do really believe in Hashem. In these times, this is the time that we need to show faith and confidence in Hashem, that Hashem knows what He's doing. Hashem natan, Hashem lakach, ishem Hashem mevorach. Hashem gave, put him in his world, Hashem took him from this world, may Hashem's name will be blessed, because Hashem knows what He's doing. And it says, v'amru chachabenu zechonam livracha, kol ha-mitkashe yoter midai lamet. He says, he who mourns too much over the dead, he says, b'me dvarim umurim b'shar ha-mavel, which means he who mourns too much over the dead, chas v'shalom, can cause another disaster in his family. But to mourn over talmid chacham, over a sage, over a scholar in Torah, this is permitted. To mourn has as much as a long over a sage, over a scholar in the Torah. Amru rabotenu zechonam livracha, sages said, echad mibnei hamishpacha shemet yidagu kol hamishpacha. If one of the family member dies, all of the family should have concern. Im vechen echad machavura shemet, and if one of the group dies, all of the group should be concerned. Why? Because Hashem says this means that you have to look at yourself to do tshuva b'siyata dishma, to come closer to me b'siyata dishma, and now to do chesed shel emet with the dead, to do a chesed, kindness of truth, with the one that passed away. And how do we do kindness of truth? Like giving shurei Torah, doing everything, reading Tehillim in his chut b'siyata, in his merit, b'siyata dishma, everything that we do, to do in his merit. This is chesed shel emet. This is kindness of truth. Why? Because we're not expecting for him to give us anything back. I wish Be'ezrat Hashem that Rabbi Haim will be a big melitz yosher for Klal Yisrael in heaven, b'shamayim, b'siyata dishma. I would like to describe you, Be'ezrat Hashem, what happens to a soul before it passes away. So it says in the Zohar HaKadosh, וכך מובא בזוהר הקדוש פרשת ויחי. אמר רבי אלעזר, רבי אלעזר said, אשריכם הצדיקים הלומדים דרכיו של הקדוש ברוך הוא. Blessed are you righteous people that are learning the ways of Hashem, כדי ללכת בהם ולראה אותו מאותו יום הדין שעתיד אדם ליתן דין וחשבון לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא. In order to fear Hashem and to go in His way before, to remember the judgment day, which is the day of death, that we give judgment in front of Hashem. And then, ביום ההוא שנשלמו ימיו של האדם, at that day, that the days of a human being were fulfilled, לצאת מן העולם, and this is the time that he is supposed to go out of the world, ביום ההוא שהגוף נשבר והנפש צריכה לפרוש ממנו. At that day when the body breaks and the soul has to depart from it, אז ניתן רשות לאדם לראות מה שלא היה יכול לראות. Then there's a permission for a human being to see what he couldn't see before while he was alive, because if we could see, we wouldn't have freedom of choice. We all us women will go with a cover on our head, will be tzniut, because we wouldn't have any freedom of choice. We will know what's going on. ואז עומדים עליו שלושה שליחים, and then three angels stand in front of him. וחושבים ימיו וחטאיו, and they calculate his days and his sins, וכל מה שעשה בעולם, and everything that he did in this world. והוא מודה על הכל בפיו, and he confesses everything with his mouth. ואחר כך חותם עליו בידו, and then he signs that everything is true. וזהו שכתוב ביד כל אדם יחתום. This is what's written, that the hand of everyone is going to sign. ובידי כולם חתומים בכל מעשה וחטאיו לדון אותו בעולם ההוא על הראשונים ועל האחרונים. Everything that he did from the beginning when he was born until he passed away. על החדשים ועל הישנים. אף אחד מהם אינו נשכח. Hashem doesn't forget anything. There's an eye that sees, an ear that listens, and all of her actions are written in a book. וכמו שכל אלו המעשים שעשה בעולם היה הוא בגוף ורוח יחד, and all the actions that he did in this world, it was the combination of the body and soul, כן הוא נותן חשבון עליהם כשהוא בגוף ורוח יחד. And he is going to give judgment upon everything that happened to him when the body and soul are together. והיינו מטרם שנפטר מן העולם. בשעה שהיא כשהוא שוכב קשור בכבלים של מלך נושא עיניו ורואים שבהם עליו שניים הכותבים לפניו את כל מעשיו שעשה בעולם הזה. And all, וכל הדיבורים שהוציא מפיו, and all of, not only the actions, but all of the words that we took out of our mouth. Everything is, we see everything, like a video we see everything. ונותן דין על הכל וכותבים לפניו. And he gives judgment over everything, and it's written in front of him, and he confesses over it. ומהו הטעם שמודה על כל מעשיו? And why does he confess over all of his actions? משום שאותו מעשה שעשה עולה ועומד לפניו להעיד בו. Because every action that we do, if we do a good deed, we create a good angel. If we do a not good deed, we create a destructive angel. So all of these angels now stand in front of the soul, in front of us before we pass away. So they say, each one will say, I was created from the Afrashat Chala that we did here. I was created when there wasn't a Shmirat Shabbat. I was created from this. So they all are standing. He has to confess. He has to sign. He has, because he can't say this didn't happen. All of these angels are standing in front of Hashem, in front of him. ויורדים כולם ונרשמים לפניו ועומדים לפניו, they are standing in front of him, ואינם עוברים ממנו עד השעה שנידון בעולם הזה. And then בסייעת הדשמיה, the soul starts to say goodbye from each part of the body, and it starts from the legs, and each part that the soul says goodbye and leaves that part, it becomes cold, because the part is dead. Because all our organs are moving because of the soul. The soul is the one that holds the body. Once the soul says goodbye to each part of the body, from the place that she went out of, the part of the body, the organ is dead already. Until it goes out, בסייעתא דשמיא, totally. And it says, וכל איברי הגוף כולם מזדעזעים. And all of the parts of the body are trembling. וכשמגיע הרוח לכל עבר בר ונפרד ממנו, נופלת זה על אותו עבר והרוח מסתלקת ממנו. ומיד מת אותו עבר. And immediately that organ dies. וכן בכל העברים. כיוון שמגיע הרוח לצאת כי כבר נפרד מכל עברי הגוף, because the soul now already said goodbye to all of the parts of the body, אז השכינה עומדת עליו. Then the divine presence is standing above him. ומיד פורחת הרוח מן הגוף. And immediately the soul goes out of the body because it wants to cling to Hashem. And this is true about righteous people and also wicked people, evil people. Everybody sees the Shekhinah. כי לא יראני אדם וחי. Once we are alive, we can't see it. But once we pass, everybody has to see it. If it's a righteous person, the divine presence is there, the Shekhinah is there, in order to escort him with all of the tzaddikim and his family that comes down to greet him, in order to tell this soul did everything that Hashem wanted her to do in this world. And if it's a wicked person, in order that the wicked person, the soul will see at whom she went against. And immediately the divine presence goes away, and all of the destructive angel takes that soul. But the righteous soul, b'siyata d'shmaya, the divine presence is escorting her with all of the tzaddikim, in all of the ones that she's going to be next in Gan Eden, in paradise. Can you just imagine this? Is this worth, doesn't this worth to do the will of Hashem in this world? This is a passing world, a world of an hour? To be tzniut? To do the will of Hashem? To keep Shabbat? Not to say, oh, I have this difficulty. There's no difficulties. It's the Yetzer Hara who builds us like a wall to have to just think that we have. We don't really have any difficulty to do the will of Hashem. It's the imaginary, the imagination that we have from Yetzer Hara, from the evil inclination. There's no difficulty to do anything. It's all in our hands. So isn't it worthwhile after all of this journey that we had? And nobody knows when they're going out of this world. So v'siyata dishma, don't we want the Bezrat Hashem that all of our family and that the righteous tzaddikim will come to greet us and the divine presence will take us to our place, to Gan Eden in heaven, to the paradise in heaven? Of course it's worthwhile to do the will of Hashem over here and not to say, oh, I have this, I can't. This is the evil inclination speaking, not us. That blocks us to see from seeing the truth. But then it waits for us on the other side with all of the destructive angels that Chas Shelo Neda, that we created by listening to it. So, Besiyata Dishmaya, I would like to tell you, Rabbi Haim lived 70 years. Yom Kippur was his birthday. 70 years, just like David HaMelech. King David also lived 70 years. And I would like to tell you that David HaMelech, I wanted to write it over here, but I forgot to write it for you. David HaMelech, Besiyata Dishmaya, the secret of David HaMelech, of King David, is life. V'chaim is life. The name of Rabbi Haim, Chaim is life. So we always say David Melech Israel Chai VeKayam, that the King David, the King of Israel, is alive and kicking. So the initials of David Melech Israel Chai VeKayam, David starts with a Dalid, Melech starts with a Mem, Israel starts with a Yud, Chai starts with a Chet, Vav VeKayam starts with a Vav. Together it equals 68, which is Chaim. So Rabbi Chaim lived 70 years equal to David Melech Yisrael Chai VeKayam, to the initials, because the secret of David Melech Yisrael, the King David, is life. B'siyata Dishmaya. And Rabbi Chaim Yosef Sharabi, B'siyata Dishmaya, fulfilled what is written in the Mishnah Masechet Avot, Al Shlosha Dvarim HaOlam Omed, on three things the world is standing: ala Torah, on the Torah, ve'ala avodah, and on work, which work is tefillah, is davening, is praying to Hashem, ve'al gmilut chasadim, acts and of kindness, deeds of kindness, besirat Hashem. On three of them, Rabbi Chaim was the one that heard, was one of the 36 lamed vav tzadikim that held the world, besirat Hashem. And it says, "Ve'eshlosha minei nedivut." There are three acts of kindness. The first one is nedivut b'mamon, is kindness with money. The second one is nedivut beguf, the second one is kindness with body. And the third one is nedivut bechokma, kindness with wisdom. Dear ladies, it says about Abraham Avinu and Rabbi Moshe and Rabbi Chaim Yosef Sharabi was Abraham Avinu of our days. In every generation, there's our forefathers, Abraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov. And I can tell you that Rabbi Chaim Yosef Sharabi was Abraham Avinu. And it says about Abraham Avinu, the kindness with the money, Vayita Eshel, that he planted a tree that is called Eshel. And these are Rashi Tevot, our initials of Aleph, of Eshel, is Achila, that he gave everybody food. Shin is Shtiya, he gave him drinks. And Lamed is Aviya, which means to escort them, besiyata dishmaya, or lina, to give them a place to sleep. And then begufo, Abraham Avinu, sheetzit Lot ben Achiv, that with his body he went and fought for Lot in order to save him from the four kings. So this is charity, kindness with his body. And bechokma, Abraham Avinu, kilimed lechol ha'am, Derech HaYashar, Ad Shenitgayru, that he taught all of the people, everybody that was willing to listen, he taught them the ways of Hashem in order that they will see that there's an owner to the world, there's a creator to the world, and he brought them back into the divine presence. Ve'et ha'nefesh asher asu b'charan. And all of the, and it's like he created the b'siyata d'ishma. This was Rabbi Haim Yosef Sharabi. Alav ha'shalom z'chutot hagan alenu, t'in ishtotot tzorot tzor ha'chaim. Rabbi Haim Yosef Sharabi, if it was winter, if it was autumn, if it was summer, if it was spring, he would go and give and spread out food to everyone, everybody that needs. He will send messengers, he will go himself to give widows and orphans money. He will speak with people in order to help them to come closer to Hashem. Azo me Rabbi Moshe Cordovero, Besiata Dishmaya. It says like this. Let's take out the books. It says Perek Gimel, ועוד מדרך החוכמה להיות משגחת על כל המציאות, that the nature of chokhmah, of wisdom, is to oversee all of existence. It's like an angel. That's what he did. He looked at everybody. Everybody felt connected to him. They're all calling me and saying, who can we speak with now? Who can help us? Who can help us see the right way? So it says, and Hashem says, "V'pnei shehi ha'machshava choshevet al ha'nimtzot," that this is the thought that is that thinks about everything that exists. And Hashem says in Yeshayahu the prophet, chapter 55, verse 8, "For my thoughts are not like your thoughts." And he says, he gives thoughts so that he is not banished forever, which means Hashem wants everybody to do tshuva. לכן לא מחשבותיי מחשבותיכם, וחשב מחשבות לבלתי ידח ממנו נידח, that even the wicked people will do תשובה and come closer to him. כי אנוכי ידעתי את המחשבות אשר אני חושב עליכם נאום השם, because I know, it says in Yirmiyahu the prophet, chapter 29, verse 11, I know the thoughts that I think about you, מחשבות שלום, thoughts of peace, ולא לרע, and not evil thoughts, לתת לכם אחרית ותקווה, I would like to give you, Hashem says, to give you hope, בסייעתא דשמיא, and goodness, בסייעתא דשמיא. And then, כך צריך האדם להיות עיניו פקוחות על הנהגת עם השם לעולם, which means, this way, every human being should think about his fellow human beings, in order to help them, not to think bad about them, to think good thoughts about them, to find good spots about them in order that they will do tshuva. You know, Rabbi Nachman Breslov says that if we find, even for an evil person, we find one good deed that he does, and we tell Hashem, you know Hashem, this is the good deed that he, this and this Ploni ben Ploni did, Hashem builds on it until he does tshuva. And then you have dividend in him and all of his generations to come, בסייעתא דשמיא. ומחשבותיו תהיינה לקרב את הנידחים, and our thoughts to be, to come, to be closer, everybody that is far away from Hashem. ולחשוב עליהם מחשבות טובות, and to think about them good thoughts. כמו שהשכל חושב תועלת הנמצא כולו. Just like Hashem thinks only for the benefit of his children. ויתייעץ עצות טובות עם השם ועם עמו בפרט ובכלל, and he should also be speaking with Hashem only good ideas and things about the children of Hashem and the children of Israel בפרט. ויוצא מהנהגה הטובה ינעלנו להנהגה ישרה ויהיה לו כמו שכל ומחשבה, and this is how he needs to think בסייעתא דשמיא in order to fix himself and others. And it says, והחוכמה in Kohelet, King Solomon says in Kohelet, chapter 7, verse 12, King Solomon says, והחוכמה תחיה בעליה. And the wisdom is going to give life to the ones who have wisdom. This is the wisdom. The wisdom is to think good about everyone, to think good about ourselves, and to think good about everyone. Because if we don't think good about ourselves, we can't lefargen to think good about others. And it says, "Kach yehu morei chaim lechol haolam." And this is mamash, it's like written about Rabbi Haim Yosef Sharabi. And his name is Haim. And this, likewise, one should instruct the entire world in the ways of life. Ze chaim. Lechol haolam, causing them to attain life in this world and in the world to come. And by giving them the wisdom and showing them the way of Hashem, you give them not only this world, but you give them the world to come. Bezrat Hashem. You give them the zchut to be in paradise in the world to come, Bezrat Hashem. And this is the role. This is the zaklal. Yeh noveh chaim lakol. He should be a constant source of life to all people, Bezrat Hashem. This is mamash, shows who Rabbi Haim Yosef Sharabi was. And it says, "V'siyata nishma v'chen lo yachshosh shim eten etza v'sechel tov la'anashim pshutim." And even a scholar in Torah, that he shouldn't be afraid to give a good advice to simple people, even people that don't, they work the whole day and just make time, Bezrat Hashem, to learn Torah. La'anashim pshutim v'shma ta'anotehem, and listen to all of the things that bother them and show them the right way. And always in the help of Hashem, Bezrat Hashem, b'siyata d'ishmaya. And v'shma ta'anotehem v'kivyechol le'abed zmano l'rik. It's not in vain. Ki adrab, because Hashem wants it. Ki adrabah tzarich liyot ma'orav im abriyot. Hashem wants us to be with His people. And why? ולפעמים נראה בזה תועלת גדולה לעבודת השם, שידע אורחות אנשים צוקותיהם, even a scholar in Torah that sits and learns Torah the whole day. He should be involved with his community, with his people, because then everything that he learned, he can now practice and give them good advice, advice of Hashem, in order to go in the right way, בסייעתא דשמיא, which is very important. ולתות ואיך לעבוד את השם, and how to worship השם. וחכם ישים לב, וחכם ישים הלב רמיזה דחוכמתה בכל מעשה ודיבור שבא לפניו, ואשרי השומע. And he says, as a wise person will take it to his heart, בסייעתא דשמיא, to do so, and blessed he who listens to this and practices it, בסייעתא דשמיא. So dear ladies, we see that Rabbi Haim Yosef Sharabi fulfilled with money. You know, he passed away on Vav, Bekislev, Motzei Shabbos of Parashat Vayetze, Besiyata Dishmaya, and Besiyata Dishmaya on the month of Kislev. And Kislev, we know, it's Kis and Lev. Kislev, Kis and Lev, which means a pocket, which means money, Velev, and a heart. He had a big heart. He loved everyone. Everybody felt loved by him. That this is the heart that he had. It's very hard to have a connection for so many people all over the world, and that everyone individually will feel that he is loved by him, that he has a ear that listens to him, that he really listens and gives them good advice in order to continue b'siyata d'ishmaya, and they feel that this is an advice from Hashem, and it's not in seeking for honor, but it's literally for Hashem's sake. L'shem Shamayim. You know, very weird things happened. One of the things, v'siyata d'ishmaya, that happened is when we sent the body to Israel, instead of the body going straight to Israel, and the second day being in Israel, and then it should be the burial, the body went to Chicago, and it stayed there a whole day, and from there it went to Israel. And we didn't sleep the whole night. They called us from Israel. We didn't know what's going on, because we know that they were supposed to put the body on the plane to Israel. And people escorted him over there, so they spoke with the people over there. So this shows us how, if we are all human beings, King Solomon says there's no righteous person in this world that will do good and won't have a sin. I would like to tell you about Rabbi Shalom Arashash, Rabbi Shalom Sharabi. Ben Yitzchak, Alav HaShalom, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu. You know, Rashash was the head of the Yeshiva Mekubalim Bet El in Yerushalayim. And when he passed away, before he passed away, he told his scholars that he wants them to throw his body in the valley. This is what he wanted them to do. And it's written, Besiyata Dishmaya, בתחילו חימו קימו התלמידים הדגולים את צוואת רבנו באשר לסדר טהרתו וקבורתו. And the scholars did exactly what he wanted with his body in order to purify him in the mikveh and everything that he told them. אך איש מביניהם לא העז ליטול על שכמו את המשימה לקיים את ציוויו באשר לעונשים כנגד ארבע מיתות בדין. But he wanted them to do for him the four deaths of the Jewish court. סקילה, שריפה, הרג וחנק, which means stoning, burning, suffocating, and killing and suffocating. They didn't dare do this. עמדו ותיעצו איך לעשות כדי לא לגרום לגוף הקדוש בזיון זה. They spoke with חברת קדישה. What shall we do? He told us to do this, but we can't do this to his body. והחליטו על דעת חברת קדישה, they decided they're not going to fulfill his will for סקילה. So בסייעתא דשמיא ציון תישא במר קולה על פני בני ירושלים פוסעים אבלים ורצוצים. Thousands of the children of Israel in Yerushalayim and other places came in order to ללוות, to go with him בסייעתא דשמיא to his last journey. And they were crying. And the Arabs over there that were seeing them were very angry. They saw so many Jewish people going after Rashash, and Hamato shel Shabab and the bullies over there in the Arabs became very angry. Ve'od ha'mita noset, and they are holding the bed which his body is on it. Mitkarevet berosh ha'tzela le'ever emek Yoshafat, when it comes to the emek, the valley of Yoshafat. Nishma lepeta kol hamon v'shon birinonim ishmaelim mechudanim itnaplu al nosei ha'mita. And we hear that Arabs came, bullies that came, and they went on the bed that they were carrying of the Rashash, and the bed fell off their hands. It fell into the valley with the body of the Rashash on it. Nivhalu v'nishtamemu atalmidim achra'u bekach etzba elokim retzon yirav yaseh. לא אהבו הם עצמם לקיים צוואת רבנו, והרי נשלחו מהשמיים השליחים. They didn't want to do what Arashash asked them, and then this is what happened, because Hashem wanted him to come cleansed, even if he had something small. Even Moshe Rabbeinu, Hashem told him that he can't go to the land of Israel, because there's no righteous person that will do good and won't have a sin. So Rashash wanted to be cleansed in this world. Rabbi Haim Yosef Sharabi, Alav HaShalom, Zchutot Hagen Aleinu, wanted also to be cleansed in this world. That's why he had to come to Chicago and then go back to Eretz Israel. And you know, he was so humble. For example, all of the weddings and all of the shiduchim that he did, he never went to say a bracha in the Sheva Brachot. He used to pay and do everything and to go out like he didn't do anything. And I was thinking, during the Levaya in Israel, instead of saying Rabbi Chaim ben David, they said Rabbi Chaim ben Yosef. It's like they weren't speaking about him. And I was saying to myself, here in his life and in his death, he is still humble. He doesn't want them to speak about him. In his life and in his death, humbleness. So it's very touching to think about it. Besiyata Dishmaya. I would like to tell you, it's written in Shir HaShirim, Dodi yarad legano, my Dodi yarad legano, la'arugot habosem, lir'ot baganim ve'lilkot shoshanim. My beloved has descended to his temple garden, to his incense altar, to graze in the gardens and to pick roses. B'siyata Dishmaya. It says b'Shir HaShirim Rabba, Dodi is Hashem Yitbarach. Yarad legano, that he descended to his temple garden, this is the world, the temple garden of Hashem created. We should keep this world beautiful like Hashem created it. Hashem created this world for us to enjoy it and to go in His way. Then there will be peace all over the world, plenty of food for everyone, happiness, shidduchim, marriages, children, everything. Once there's peace, there's everything. Hashem bestows goodness and wealth over all the world once there's peace. So it says, Yarad Legano, to descend to His temple garden, this is the world, this world. La'arukot ha'bosem, to His incense altar, b'siyata d'shmeya, these are the children of Israel. Lir'ot baganim, to graze in the gardens, these are the shuls, the synagogues, and the yeshivot. And Talmudei Torah v'siyata d'shmeya. Velilkot shoshanim, and to pick up roses. Lesalek et ha-tzadikim shebi Yisrael, to pick up the righteous from the children of Israel, because they atone for the children of Israel. I would like to tell you, Be'ezrat Hashem, that this was Rabbi Haim Yosef Sharabi, that Hashem came to his garden and just picked up a rose and took the rose with him. And Be'ezrat Hashem, I would like to bless all of us, because we are orphan generation. All of the righteous tzaddikim are going one after the other. So we need to wake up. There's no time.
And
I would like to bless all of you in Klal Yisrael and the whole world, Be'ezrat Hashem. Hashem bless us with peace. And
Amen.
May we never see sorrow. And b'siyata d'shmeya v'bila mavet lanetzach, that Be'ezrat Hashem, Hashem will already reveal Mashiach, and that we will all have the zchut Be'ezrat Hashem to greet Mashiach and to see all of our beloved ones that are not in this world anymore, and to have the zchut to see the tzadikim and tzadikot all over Be'ezrat Hashem. I love you all. I would like to bless all of us that we all have the zchut to greet Mashiach. Tzidkan barachamim uim imrabi amenu amen. Eliyahu navi zachur latov. Nolam yipared adam mechaverov idbar alacha yachid berabim alacha kerabim. I love you all. Talinu betov ותקיצו בישועה ורחמים. סגרת?
I love you, Rabbanit. Thank you so much.
I love you all.
You're wonderful.
We love you, girls.
סגרת את זה?
We love you too.